There are various enhancements to railings, including capabilities to define continuous rail transitions, terminations, and supports. First, let's take a look at how to define continuous rail transitions. In the Type Properties dialog, the default transitions is gooseneck. Another choice is simple. Gooseneck is used when there's a tight transitions and complex rail profiles. And simple is used where there are tight transitions with a circular rail profile. Second enhancements, in the type properties, under terminations, you can choose a terminations for the beginning, bottom, or end top termination. Let's choose a termination wood rectangular for the beginning bottom. Notice that the termination has been added to the railing. Lastly, you can define a continuous rail supports. Supports can only be added to handrail, not top rail. In the supports category, you can specify the family type. In this case, we'll choose support metal circular. We will define a fixed system layout with a 5 feet spacing and justification to center. After defining the support location and spacing, you can override the location of the support individually by using drag or standard modification tools such as move. The capabilities to define railing transitions, terminations, and supports enables creation of railings more accurately.